quite a challenging one for your upper body, and it perhaps would not be ideal if you have a lot of pelvic dysfunction, if you have a prolapse or any of those sort of challenges. So this one is probably not what I would call pelvic floor safe, but you are going to be using your arms quite a lot. So we are using the step and assist ball. You're going to be starting off by facing the step and sitting on the assist ball. Then we're going to be doing some tricep dips. So you want to make sure also that your wrists don't have, you don't have any too much pathology or anything really wrong with your wrists. We try and see if it's okay. Some people find the angle is fine for their wrists. But you are going to spread your fingers out as wide as you possibly can. And then what you want to do is place your feet up on top of the step. Lift yourself off the ball. Now for some people, this is the biggest challenge. And this is quite an effective workout for those muscles at the back, because it is movement. You're trying to hold and stabilize that ball. So what you can do is attempt to be able to hold this for at least 30 seconds, or if it look, maybe a little bit longer before you decide to progress onto the next exercise. So the next exercise is to actually make sure that you bend and straighten your arms. So you're bending and straightening the arms. This is the next progression, progression number one. So just bend the elbows, coming down, coming up. So you might be thinking, well, I could do this with my feet on the floor, and that's true. But what you want to do is actually use the height of the step, which I'm going to demonstrate in just a moment. Just make sure that when you are moving yourself up and down, or your clients are moving up and down, that they bend and straighten their elbows and not come and thrust it. Okay? That will make them look quite unstable. Alright, so progression number two is to actually tap the floor, yes, as you move yourself down and up. So you can tap down as you go down, or what you can do is go down and tap the floor as you go up. They're slightly different. It requires a bit more strength for this second one, a little bit more challenging to hold yourself up while you're moving that foot. Yep. So that would be progression number two. So you've got two options of how you're going to do that. Tap the floor when you go down, or tap the floor as you come up. So coming up is a little harder. Okay, so if I was teaching a class, I would do around about a block of each. It's really important as instructors that you give people a bit of a rest. And some people's wrists are not going to handle that stabilization period for a really lengthy period of time. You want to make sure that people are getting good quality movement rather than just thrashing them so that they're really sore. Okay, so progression number three. Oh yes, there's more. So progression number three, again, fingers on either side of the wall, feet back up onto the step. But this time, instead of tapping the floor with the toe, extend the leg out to the front. So stretching out, coming back up, stretching out, coming back up. And again, you've got two options here. You can tap the floor as you go down, which is a little bit easier than tapping the floor as you come up. So tapping the floor as you come up is a little harder. Breathe out, breathe in. Again, I'll be doing this for approximately one block. Give people a break, maybe do it again. Okay, the final exercise option is you have your feet out straight on the step, so you might need to sit on the wall first. So feet straight out the step, as straight as you can make it, and then bend the elbows. Now this is really challenging. This is really hard work. Because you're a little bit higher away from the floor, and your triceps are working so much harder. You can straighten the legs more, but just keep this in mind. The taller the person, the longer the arms, the longer the legs, the harder all these exercises are. You know, I'm not very tall, so I can get away with having my knees still slightly bent but extended out on the step. It's a really tough upper body workout because you're constantly trying to manage that ball underneath you. It's the instability that gets more muscle fibers recruited rather than it being a balanced exercise for your arms. So great exercise for the upper body. It's really, really simple. I haven't had to add weight or heavy weights to get that overload, and I've been able to do that in a very short period of time. And that's this week's muscle conditioning too.